Yes, yes, my people. What's happening? Boy, I thought, let me...
Who are you barking at?
So I'm just going to take out one of my dogs, my original, well, my first ever American XL Bully female, Laska. I'm going to take her for a walk, have a little walk and stuff, have a little walk and talk, because, yeah, man, I'm not really going to be able to bring her out soon like that and let her off the lead and all of them things there. So I thought, why not get a little video? She's getting older as well now. She's coming up to about 6 or something like that years old. So I thought, yeah, let's just get this last, well, not this last time, obviously she's still gonna be about and stuff like that up until the band. And then she's gotta, unfortunately, wear a muzzle. I don't know if it's gonna be like tattoos and all of that sort of thing, but she's gotta be muzzled up and stuff. So, and then she's not gonna be allowed off the lead and all of that stuff. So while we can, thought, let's just go and have a little walk and talk. And then, yeah, man, it's gonna be the last sort of times, man, you're gonna see American XL's off the lead. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, because again, you know my thoughts on it. A lot of people didn't do the correct training and the correct learning about the breed, let's say, before we had everybody investing in a bully. I remember when I used to do the training and stuff like that back in the day, I used to do like the protection work and obviously the obedience and all that sort of stuff. When I used to do that, bro, I remember people used to message me like, you shouldn't be doing that with the dog. You shouldn't be doing this with the dog. You shouldn't be doing that. And all of this. And yeah, now look where we're at, bro. So yeah, I've just pulled up. I'm gonna get Laska out, let her go do her thing. Because yeah, as I said, American XL Bullies ain't gonna be allowed off their lead and without a muzzle in public in England soon. So I'm gonna let her soak up most of the time. I would have brought Keela as well. Obviously she does everything with Keela as well. So it's good to have some one-on-one bonding time with her. Just do a little walk and that. So yeah, all right, cool, let's go, my people. Boy, it's not looking good for the American XL Bullies, bruv. Yeah, bruv, I'll break some of it down. So when did I start this now? So yeah, it's coming up 8 years. 8 years I got my first bully, Boozy, bruv. 8 years ago, man. Remember walking him around and stuff and people was wondering like, what dog is that? What sort of dog is that?
Oh my God, what is that? Oh my God, what is that?
And I was telling everybody, it's a bully. And mum was like, what, bulldog? American bulldog or bulldog? I was like, nah, it's a new thing. It's American bully. And people were shocked, man. Let's say like they took the scene, bruv, by surprise, bruv. There was quite a few people. There was a little short niche community and that. There was a good few people. I remember the OGs like Simon Lyons Lair, Ricky, Pit Pound. You've got all sorts of kennels there that was starting up, but they were the main ones that I was sort of watching. And what's the other kennel called? I'll put their ting anyway in there, innit, buddy? Like, they had Tommy Gunn anyway, innit, yeah? Big boy kennels, innit, yeah? And then obviously Lion's Lair had Nero. I think it was NW Kennels, a geezer called Noble. He had Rhino. Them lot was on the scene, and Ginge as well. You know what I mean? They was more like doing the athletic dogs and stuff like that, more the athletic type. And then obviously Lion's Lair had a variety, had Nero the Tank as well, that was doing bits and pieces and stuff like that, bro. Obviously, yeah, can't forget man like Power Chains as well. Power Chains, he was one of the OGs as well in this thing. He was like one of the first to get that Hulk blood into the UK as well. The bullies go back far, like very, very far before the peak. Let's say I'm in it 8 years. These man, it's probably like 12, 13 years, 14 years of bullies in the UK. I'm trying to think when it started, like the craze sort of started, bruv. Like when everybody was like so onto a bully and stuff like that. Do you get me? I'm trying to think, when did the craze start? Anyway, yeah, like it got to a point where a lot of people were just onto bullies, bruv. Like everyone was just trying to get a bully. Because when I first started, I remember telling my mates like, rah, like I'm gonna put my time and effort into these dogs and stuff, start my own little kennels, start my productions and obviously try and make the lit dogs, do you get me? It was like, everyone was looking at man like, rah, like, what are you doing, bro? Do you know what I'm saying? Like, what are you doing? What are you doing? And I was saying, bro, I've got a vision, trust me, innit? You're gonna see, innit? It started moving forward. So then I got Laska. So I got Laska off a guy called Paul Street, yeah? Big him up, man. Cause I'm telling you right now, that brother put me on with my first ever American bully female, which is her, Laska. Come on, Las. Eating up this grass, bro. Let's go and get some probiotics in that, bro. Yeah, so that was Laska now, yeah? That was my first ever female. So Watch this now. It was me, Boozy, Lionel, and my ex-missus in a flat now. Do you get what I'm saying? So Lionel being my French bulldog as well, yeah? Obviously, I was talking about American bullies, but I had a Frenchie from the start as well. Lass! And a Frenchie from the start as well, which is man like Lionel, yeah? We was all in the flat, and basically there wasn't enough room for Laska. So I got to big up her mate, Stephen Brick. He held on to Laska for us to get a house, because we said we were gonna get a house. So he held on to Laska for us to get a place. Laska was like the drive to get man out of the flat into a property.
You have any idea how fast I really am? I'm fast as fuck, boy.
She didn't even know she's gonna have to wear a muzzle in that soon, man. Bloody pisses me off, bro. Hill. See the obedience, yeah? Watch it. Stephen held on to her for a little bit for us to get into a property. Yeah, and that's when it was like, yo, man started taking this thing serious. I started seeing like a lot of people. I'm linking up with kennels. I'm seeing kennels. Obviously, I had a missus at the time. Proper supportive as well. Not going to be one of them geezers that's going to be here trash talking or whatever like that. So obviously she knows who she is anyway. So I ain't going to do all this chatting thing. But yeah, like, do you know what I mean? There was never a time where I was bringing a dog home and she was like, ah, why are you bringing this dog and stuff like that? So very supportive at the time in what I wanted to do, because previous life and stuff like that, man was getting into Laska Hill. Previous times, man was getting into a lot of trouble, bits and pieces. You know how it goes when you're younger, you know what I mean? You think you know all the ways and stuff like that. You think you've got all the better plans, but yeah. It weren't looking too good for me, bro. We got Lucci and RIP Lucci, and we got Keela. So we got them two there. And it's crazy because like people weren't supporting that. Do you know, people weren't supporting man's thing with the dogs and stuff like that. And I'll say her mum and dad were like the first people to like proper support it. And do you know what I mean? Help man out towards it and stuff like that. So you got to never forget where you come from in this thing. Do you know what I'm saying? And I'll never forget where I come from. And obviously them lot helped man and push this thing. So this was years before the craze and all of that started, like everybody started getting them. So we was up in the mix of it. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Like doing this little thing. I remember going to my first ABKC show down in England as well. It was big, man. And like, I'll be real, like, bruv, these dogs changed my life. They've changed my life, changed my view on life, changed what I do, how I move. If it wasn't for Boozy, I don't know where man would be. And I'm not gonna talk for everybody. Yeah, my situation was I was in a lot of trouble, obviously doing a lot of flipping stuff that I shouldn't have been doing, and then just escalated. So these dogs give man a sense of responsibility. Like, do you know what I mean? I couldn't really do so much rubbish now because, do you know what I mean? You've got to come home to your dogs and sort out your dogs. Do you know what I'm saying? Like even like cleaning up piss and shit in your yard, like because that you've took long to get home and stuff like that. I had to adapt to, because my life before that, I was on this drip, 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 drown thing. You think I'd be out in Crocs and thick socks, blood? But I was on the swagalicious one. I thought I was the swag man.
Your trousers are funny, fam. Levi jeans. Levi jeans. Karate trousers.
Yeah? So yeah, man, it grew me up properly. Like I was already like a young G, let's say, that was already grown. You know what I'm saying? Like I knew what I wanted to do. Like I do what I wanted to do. I sort of fended for myself. Do you know what I mean? My mum brought me up in that way. Do you get me? Just the fundamentals of obviously, do you know what I mean? Being a man, taking responsibility for stuff like this. And as much as people say stuff like, these are like my kids. So before I eat, these lot I eat it, and making sure that they've got food on the table and being able to do these sort of things. Wait, look, there's some dogs over there. So what I'll do, let me clip her up in here. Come here, come here. All right, cool. So yeah, they just grew man up and that, you get me? And everything like that. So I know a lot of people that's got the bullies and stuff like that, they're telling me like, do a video, do stuff and things. And I had to explain like, this is more personal than me. I didn't get a couple dogs, let's say, and then think I was the man and diddy-dee-dee. Like this stuff actually changed my life. And I see a lot of people chatting a lot of rubbish, like, yeah, this dog changed my life and all of that. And it's like, yeah, the dog financially changed your life. You get what I'm saying? But I'm not coming with a finance thing. You get what I'm saying? Finance is here or there, bruv, we've survived, you know what I mean? And that's all that it takes. And now, do you know what I mean? I've opened up businesses and stuff like that. So them dogs have financially changed man's life and stuff like that. I'm not coming from a financial point of standing. Laska's had two litters in her life and that. And yeah, like, do you know what I mean? Obviously, yeah, it's good to get a peas and stuff and do your thing. But do you know what I'm saying? It weren't no groundbreaking stuff that changed her life. It just made sure that, do you know what I mean? They had better stuff. And that's what I did every time, like, I had a litter. And I've owned, like, people don't even get this as well, innit, yeah? I've only had three litters, yeah? Myself. Do you get what I'm saying? So that's with Keela and Laska, my in-house females. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So Laska's had two litters, Keela's had one litter. Do you get me? I own businesses in the dog community to do with things and stuff, but I don't save because I don't like to be hovering over the businesses. They do what they do, and I'm glad they do stuff, but we didn't come up off puppies and stuff like that. Do you get what I'm saying? So now I'm here, like, they're getting banned. And for me, I'm upset. I'm pissed because she's got to now walk around with a muzzle, maybe have to have a tattoo. She's obviously got to get neutered, but I was gonna neuter her anyway. So it don't make a difference to me in my life because these are my pets. The only difference it's gonna make is obviously they're gonna need to be insured. They're gonna need all of these sort of things. But at the end of the day, she's with me until she dies, bro. And same as Keela, the same as Boozy. They're my original OGs. Obviously RIP Lionel as well because he passed away. Obviously, he's the first of the original pack to pass away. So obviously, RIP to him. But other than that, it's just like, yeah, man, I hope everybody just makes sure that their dogs are in check now. They use this to see, like, yo, it could happen to anybody. Like the Cane Corsos, the Pressers, the Baubles, all of them sort of breeds, all of them sort of dogs. All I can do is say to people with other big bull breeds and stuff like that, just keep control of these dogs, bruv. Just keep control of them, bruv, because at any minute, you can see they just want to ban your thing and stuff like that. And we can all say it's the owners and it's the this, it's the that. But listen, let's not be blaming anybody and let's just look at it for what it is and look at where we're at here. And where we're at right now here in this state, in the UK, with this American Bully breed, it's crazy. Yeah, I didn't think that it would get like this. Obviously, I knew it was getting very overpopulated and stuff like that. Everyone's cousin, brother, has got a bully and stuff like that now, but I didn't realize it was gonna get to this banned state. But my heart goes out to the people that's obviously being attacked, and do you know what I mean? There's been fatal attacks as well, and my heart goes out to it because they wasn't created to do that. Do you know what I'm saying? But lack of stimulation, lack of knowledge with dogs, not just breeds, yeah? Just all-round dogs, lack of knowledge, is why we're where we're at, basically. So I hope everybody just, do you know what I mean? I hope everyone just uses this and says to themselves, before getting a dog, find a trainer and then get a dog and go straight into training. You don't have to be embarrassed about getting training as well. You haven't got to be embarrassed about none of that because at the end of the day, people are there to help your situation and help what you've got going on. That's why there's trainers there. Don't leave it till the last minute to get training and stuff like this because look what's happening. Look what's happening. Everybody knows it all until we end up in a situation like this. And that for itself is crazy. Do you know what I'm saying? That for itself is crazy. It should never be like that, bruv, whatsoever, man. So I'm upset that it's got to where it's got to with this. All I could do is just do right by my dogs now and just do right by whatever legislation they want to put in and stuff like that because they didn't ask me to purchase them or to have litters or whatever like that. So the least that I can do is make sure now times are hard for these lot. I'm by their side, bruv. And that's it, innit? So some of us don't shout it out and have to do all of this screaming and shouting and all this protesting and stuff like that, because that's just not me. Do you know what I'm trying to say? But deep down, I'm genuinely hurt and I'm upset. Not for anything else, but my dog just having to live this sort of life now. Do you get what I'm saying? Obviously, yes, lass, come here. So yeah, bruv, soon she's gonna have to wear a muzzle and I don't think she's gonna get on well with a muzzle, but it's all training, bruv, do you know what I'm saying? And at the end of the day, it's something that I probably should have trained for, but she's not a dog like that, but it's always good, you never know. I might have to take her to a vet's or something like that and she might not like it and she might need a muzzle. So look at this, more fool me for not teaching her about muzzles and stuff like this. And this is why I've got to teach her now. I've got to teach an old dog new tricks, eh? I want to say as well, thank you to La Rockmore, man. Look at my jacket. Look pon me ting. Yo, look pon me ting. La Roquemore thing, you know? Pattern man up, so look, make sure you lot hit up La Roquemore for your jackets, innit, yeah? Make sure you lot hit up La Roquemore for your jackets. Waterproof ting. As you can see, I'm out here. It's raining. Man ain't caring about no rain and that. We're just gonna get it and just enjoy the last times that we can walk them off the lead and just let them be a little free, man, because might end up a bloody banned breed, bro. Well, it's looking highly like it. Anyway, all we can do is right by them. Without them, you wouldn't have got this side of Central. God knows where I'd be. I always say it, God knows, bro. I'm so thankful that they showed me my purpose in life, and everybody's purpose ain't the same. You feel me? Everybody's purpose is, do you know what I mean, different. People do different stuff. People roll with different people. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, and just do you. I'm always saying, don't let nobody put you off on what you're doing and stuff like that, because if I'd listened to my mates back then when they was telling me, bruv, what you doing and all of that sort of stuff, we wouldn't be here now. And I'm not saying we're here like we're somewhere, and definitely not with this stuff that's happening to the breed, but at the end of the day, we could have been in a lot worse a place. If you was to tell my teachers in school, because look at that, like, but man didn't last too long in the school. You got to look, year 8, I was kicked out of school, done and dusted. My teachers now, if you was to tell them, look at man with the animals, look at man with the monkeys, just look at man doing man's thing, they would be very shocked, bro. So we're literally gonna bop back to the car. She's just doing her little thing. Just look, she, do you know what I'm saying? She just wants to be around the man, them and that, man. She's got all the spots to run, do her thing, but she's just here, man. And this is why I appreciate her, and this is why I love the breed, because on the news, they only show the breed doing this, looking scary, doing all this fucking shit, innit, yeah? But then they don't show, like, the side of the breeds, and probably as well, it's my fault, because I could have went on the news and done stuff, but I didn't want to go on the news and talk because I didn't want to get manipulated and twisted and stuff. I'm not like some serious media guy that, do you know what I'm saying, bruv? Like, if you know me, you know where I come from, innit? So I'm not going to go on the news and let them like manipulate it and make it seem like something that is not and everything like that. So maybe, yeah, I do have a part to blame of the news not getting to see the other sides of the dogs and the dogs that's been training and stuff like that. And big you up whoever's gone on the news and tried to say your part, man, and do your part for the breed, because at the end of the day, I've heard people say like idiots are going on the news and saying stuff and whatever, but they're trying, innit? They're trying, man. And all we can do is just appreciate everybody's bit of effort that they have trying to support the breed not getting banned. It's going to be very difficult, I think, with this band, and like there's already enough homeless dogs as it is. I'll put a scroll on there of Gumtree, we'll put it up, of Gumtree right now, of American Bullies, yeah? And people are still breeding now. So when you deep it and you look at it for what it is and stuff like that, these homes, like these dogs trust, all of these things, they're gonna be rammed to the brim, and all of these dogs, a lot of these dogs are gonna end up euthanized. And this is what's sickening about it, yeah? Is there's not enough good owners whatsoever, bruv, yeah? An idiot person is gonna create an idiot dog. That's how I'm gonna put it, innit, yeah? I'm a bit blunt. And that's not what man's trying to create. Thought we'll have a little walk and talk, because yeah, man, it's getting ridiculous now. You're probably not gonna see me at the protests. You might see me on some podcast having a talk. Other than that, man, it's just gonna be what it is, man. I'm gonna follow all the rules that the government set. I'm gonna follow every single rule that they set, because I'm not trying to lose my dogs for other people's mishaps and other people's training. So, yep, it's gonna be an expense, and it's gonna be a cost a month for their insurance and whatever like that. But these are my dogs. This is what I've chose to do in life. And we're riding till the wheels fall off. That's how I've grown up. My mum's never taught me to leave a mate behind. So I'll never leave one of my dogs behind, innit? And I expect all you people that's bought your dogs as well and bought these bullies, I expect you not to leave your dogs behind. And all you mugs that have just put your dogs up for sale because of this and that, shame on you, man. Disgusting.
It's disgusting.
But anyway, everybody like and subscribe, innit? But make sure you subscribe to my thing, because we're really knees deep in with these animals, innit, yeah? And these other people that are claiming that they are and whatever, big you lot up, man. I hope you lot still got your dogs next year and the year after that and the year after that. Let's go.